This video is sponsored by A Juice. In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can create amazing motion graphics by using text and shape elements in After Effects. It is pretty simple and eye-catchy design inspired by one of the Video Hive template. Hey guys, this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's open After Effects and get started. Alright, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and let's start by creating a new composition. So it's very simple. Click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition, and this is gonna be the main composition. So let's call it main. Set the size of this project 1920 in width, 1080 in height, which is the full HD resolution. But if you want to create this animation in 4K, you have to select 4K preset from here. And here we have the frame rate. So in this case, I am using 60 frames per second for smooth animation. Duration, make it 5 seconds long. Background color black. Hit OK. Now we have to create a white background. So just go to layer, go to new, and take a new solid layer. You can also hit Ctrl Y to take a new solid. Select the white color. Hit OK. After that, we have to create shape elements. So just select the rounded rectangle tool. Just deselect all the layers. Click on fill, set it to solid color, click on stroke and set it to none, and we have to select a color. So in this case, I'm using this color. Hit OK. You can select any color that you like, and let's create a rectangular shape just like that. Open the rectangle one, rectangle path one. Here we have the side, and here we have to unlink the width and height. So click on this button. I'm going to set the width value 800 and height value 450. Let's set the roundness value to 60. Perfect. And after that, we have to set the anchor point in the center. So it's very simple. Select the move tool first. Select the layer, hold control on the keyboard, and just double click on the span behind tool to set the anchor point in the center. After that, we have to align the shape in the center. So select the move tool first. Just go to the align. If you don't have the align, then go to window and check this option align. Click on the align horizontally, align vertically. Now it is in center. And then we have to animate the size parameter. So it's very simple. Just go to 2 seconds. Turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the size parameter. Just go to 1 second. Here we have to set the width value for 50. And here we have this type of animation, but this animation is linear right now, so we have to make it smoother. Just select both the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor, highlight this point, drag this handle to the left hand side. Just like that. And if you don't have this type of graph, then right click on this graph editor, click on edit a speed graph, and then you can close the graph editor. And here we have nice and simple animation. You can close the layer. Before we proceed further, let's take a look at the amazing pack I Want It All bundle from ThankYou. It is one of the best pack for After Effects on the internet. This pack includes premium as well as free tools and plugin for After Effects that hopefully increase your production and save you so much time and efforts. Some elements of this pack including seamless transitions, shape elements, whiteboard animation, text presets, and much more for absolutely free. All the links will be in the description, so just go to the link in the description and check this out. After that, we have to create 5 different copies of this shape layer. So hit Ctrl D to duplicate. Here we have the second layer. Let's change the size of the shape. So find the size parameter, which is over here. Go to 2 seconds, where we have created a keyframe. I'm gonna place the value 250 in height and 400 in width. Now just go to 1 second, and here height value 250 and width value 250. Now let's change the color of this shape layer. So you can close the shape, select the shape layer, go to color, and for this one I'm gonna use this type of color. And obviously we have to create one more copy, so select the third shape layer, hit Ctrl D to duplicate, open the layer and find the size parameter. Just go to 2 seconds. I'm going to set the value 160 in height and 600 in width. Just go to 1 second and do the same thing. We have to set the height value 160 and width value 160. After that, let's change the color. Just like that, hit OK. Now you can close the shape layer and create a duplicate. So this is the fourth shape layer. We have to change the size first. So open it up. Here we have the size parameter. Just go to 2 second. For this one, we have to set the value 60 in height and 500 in width. Just go to 1 second. Let's set the value 60 in height, 60 in width. And finally, we have to change the color. So for this one, I'm gonna use this red color, maybe just like that. Hit OK. And finally, we have to create one more copy. Hit Ctrl D to duplicate, open it up and find the size parameter. Just go to 2 second. And for the last one, I'm gonna set the height value 120, width value 200. Just go to 1 second. And again, we have to make it round. So I'm gonna set the height value 120 and width value 120. All right, now let's change the color. Select the layer, just go to over here and select a purple color, just like that. Hit OK. Now you can close the shape layer. All right, so as you can see, we have something like this. After that, we have to create animated text. So it's very simple. Select the text tool, just go to character. If you don't have the character, you can go to the window and check this option, character. And here we have to select our favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using the Gotham Ultra font style. Of course, you can use any font style that you like. Let's set the size of the text to 80. You can set the size according to you. You can turn off the all caps option. Click over here and type anything that you like. Just like that. We have to align the text in the center. So hit Ctrl A to highlight all. And we have to do one more thing. Just go to the paragraph and check this option, center text, and then go to the align. And here we have to align it to the center. All right. And now let's animate the text first. So open the text. Here we have the animate. So click on the animate and add a parameter position. All right, and we have to add two more parameter, which is the opacity and the tracking, but in the same animator one, not in the different animator. So what we have to do, we have to click on the add button, not the animate. So click on the add button, go to property and add the opacity parameter in the same animator one, and then do the same thing. Just click on the add button, go to property, and here we have the tracking. Here we have the position. So I'm going to set the Y position value 150, which is the pre-calculated value. You can put the value according to you. And here we have the opacity. Let's set the opacity 0% and tracking amount minus 60. All right. And then just go to 1.5 second over here. Open the range selector one. And here we have the start. Let's set the start value 100. Turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the start parameter and go to the very first frame and set the start value 0. And now we will get this type of animation, and obviously it is not looking good. So select both the keyframes, hit F9 on the keyboard to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor, and again, we have to place the CDI at the center of these two keyframes over here. Highlight this point, hold this handle and just drag it like this. Make sure the peak point of the graph is in center, just like that. And now you can see the result, which is looking absolutely perfect. All right, now you can close the text layer and the graph editor. After that, we have to place these shape elements according to the text. So select the move tool, select the first shape layer and place it over here. Maybe you can use the shift and arrow key to move the shape according to you. Perfect. And you will get this type of design, as you can see. Now we have to animate all the shape layers. So just go to 1.5 second over here. Select all the shape layers, hit P on the keyboard to open the position property. Turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe for all the shape layers. You can select all the shape layers by holding shift, just like that. And then go to very first frame of this animation, move all the shape layers outside of the frame on the left hand side. Select all the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor, highlight these points, hold these handles and drag it like this on the left hand side and create a nice and simple smooth animation. Alright, now we have to create a time gap between each shapes, so you can place these keyframes randomly, something like so. After that we have to hold this position half a second, so just move the CTI on 2 seconds over here and click on the diamond button to lock the position for all the layers, and then just go to 1.5 second forward in time, which is 3.5 second, and select all the layers, hold shift and drag it to the right hand side by holding shift and right arrow key like this, and then hold this position for 0.5 second, so move the keyframe 0.5 second forward in time, and again click on the diamond button to lock the position as it is for all the layers, and then just go to the end of this animation, hold shift on the keyboard. This time we have to press left arrow key and move all the shapes on the left hand side. Alright, it's looking nice. And then we have to add drop shadow effect for these colorful layers. So select the first layer, go to effect and preset, search for drop shadow. So this is the drop shadow effect. Let's drag and drop on the first one. And here we have to set the opacity 25%, distance 40, softness 100. Alright, and now we have to pick the shadow color according to the shape color. So select the color picker and pick this color for the shadow. And now it's looking like this, and do the same thing for all the layers. So select the drop shadow, hit Ctrl C to copy and paste the drop shadow effect for all the shape layers by hitting Ctrl V on the keyboard. And then we have to change the color one by one. So select the second shape layer, pick the color picker and pick this color, and do the same thing for all the shape layers. Perfect. Now we will get something like this. After that we have to create one more copy of the text layer. So select the text layer, hit Ctrl D to duplicate. This time we have to change the font style. So just go to the character. I'm gonna use normal Gotham font style. So this is the Gotham font style. Let's set this to bold, and here we have to turn on the all caps. Now let's down the size. I'm gonna set the value 40 pixel. Select the second text layer, hold shift on the keyboard and press down arrow key and place the text in this corner, and after that you can change the text just like that. Now we have to turn on the motion blur, so click on the toggle switches if you don't have the motion blur option, and then turn on the motion blur for each layers. Let's go to very first frame, go to full screen and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikas and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.